Welcome to another episode of FarmAnywhere's Grow Guide. Today we're going to be growing cilantro from coriander seeds. We're going to go through the entire process from seeding to the nursery to harvesting. Interesting fact, it's a cut and repeat crop, which means we're going to plant it only once, come back and be able to harvest up to 8 weeks at a time from that same crop. So as usual, we're going to get going by cleaning our environment and by gowning up. All right, so we're in the lobby right here. So we're gonna unwrap the rockwool. What I like about having wrapped rockwool, especially when I keep it in the lobby, is that it kind of keeps them clean and sanitized. So, but you could always get them unwrapped, and they're a little bit cheaper if you get them unwrapped. Obviously, you don't have to use rockwool. There's plenty of medias out there to use. So you've seen previous episode, we would take the holes and make them a little bit bigger, and that's obviously time consuming, and we've had feedback from the farmers saying that it's time consuming. So we're developing this tool. You're getting a bit of a sneak peek, and you'll see when we have it officially released. But what this do is a two-in-one. It makes the holes bigger, and then we could drop the seed in faster because of these form factor that we have right here. So all we're gonna do right here is just line ourselves up with the holes like so, and press down. This will separate it, and there you go. That's what it looks like, and then we're gonna do that again. Eventually, we'll have the whole pad done in one shot. Drop that in, and then we're gonna take our cilantro seeds, like so, and all we're gonna need to do is drop it in each of the holes like so. So as you can see, it's way faster. And if you could see right there, I didn't quite get it on the first try, but I could just push it in very easy. So we still want to do a few tweaks on this before we release it as an actual product. You don't have to buy a farm. You can also just buy it separately like that. So we're going to keep doing that. So another thing that's very important, if you're not separating the holes big enough when it comes to cilantro seeds, basically the shell will not open up and then you'll have a failure. So you wanna make sure that the hole is big enough or that there's enough space for the shell to open up. So I'm gonna go ahead and just finish all this, pull the seeding tray out and move towards wetting the actual rockwool as well too. All right, so now that it's all seeded, I'm just gonna come in right here, and you can use pH water. Actually, it's recommended to use pH water, but we're doing so many of those that just medium hot, lukewarm water is good enough just to kind of get the seed started. And we're just gonna go in and wet the rock wool. So just so that it's quite damp, because in the nursery, to save on labor and to save on man hours and movements as well inside the farm, we never really want to come back and do a step again. So we're just gonna make sure that it has enough water for it to survive the 1 week of it being in the nursery, and you never have to go back at it again. And therefore, that's what it looks like. What I can do is use this tool again and just kind of push the seeds gently back in there just to kind of seed them properly. There you go, that looks pretty good. And then you can see what the final product looks like, a nice seeded tray in half the time of doing it manually without it costing thousands of dollars from a seeding machine. So now what we're going to do is bring it into the nursery room and get it set up for its 1 week of incubation. All right, so now we're going to move this into the nursery. And we never want to step back, right? So more nursery, harvest, and pack. Let's go. All right, so we're gonna just put it right here. We're gonna put the dome on top, like so, and close the vents because we want maximum humidity. So we're gonna check back every day, but in about a week, where they're gonna be mini, mini sprouts, and we're gonna be ready to send it in. So if you like this video, like. If you have any questions, comment below. And if you want to follow all of the different grow recipes that we're putting out in the container farm and life as a container farmer, subscribe to our channel to learn more. We'll see you on the next one. Also, my marketing girls are a pain in the ass, so they're asking for you to follow on Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and link in the description below. Follow us to see more on what we're working on.